Hey guys, so today I had some things to do after work, so I had to make it a really quick workout. So I decided to grab a kettlebell and do some goblet squats and some overhead presses. And it got me thinking, after I did a couple of goblet squats, I noticed that it wasn't comfortable still. So I still lack consistency in, going ATG without, just lower back weakness. So I actually really wanted to see what causes my butt wink today, which is why I actually started filming. So as you can see, these are my earlier sets. So I know the kettlebell is still a little bit too forward, not close to me, but this was actually due to me trying to counterweight sitting back. And as you can see, when I started, my narrow stance was uncomfortable, so I winded it up a little bit, and I was bare feet. So as you can see later in the video, elevating it slightly by like a centimeter helped a lot. But I think my ankle mobility is not the issue when I'm wearing weightlifting shoes. I pushed my knees out, but my butt still winks. And when I get on top, my lumbar curve is a little bit too arched. And I could feel my lower back working a little bit too much, which means that my core isn't working, whereas my lower back is trying to pull me up. So these were some bad signs, so I was trying to figure out how to resolve these issues. So first I put plates on my heels about a centimeter to a centimeter and a half. So these are lower than weightlifting shoes. And after this, my lumbar curve definitely reduced a lot. And my knees are traveling like an inch over my toes, so I think this is actually enough of knee flexion. But still, my hips seem to be very restricted when it's going into the hole, as if it doesn't fit in there. And I could definitely feel my adductors and my glutes still being very inflexible. So the wider stance helped, and keeping the lumbar curved, trying to keep it not arched. So this is actually, in my head, I thought it was like a straight back almost, not even neutral, but straight. But in hindsight, after watching the video, what I feel like is a neutral back is actually still very arched. So I think I'm just very used to having a very arched lumbar curve and a very anteriorly shifted hip in daily life. So yeah, I was trying to shove my hips between my legs, doing some pseudo paw squats, I guess, while straightening my chest up, raising my chest and keeping that core tight. So this definitely helped, but I think I need to play around more with that neutral back idea. I think the stance-wise, it's okay. And trying to shove my hips between my legs as a stretch, I think definitely helps out. So I think I'm going to do some... some paw squats, but with a neutral back. And I think I need to keep in mind to keep a neutral back in daily life. And I'm actually going to show you some clips in slow motion. Just a little experiment I did to actually see if what difference things makes. So this is just me doing the goblet squat without thinking about anything, just with some elevation in my heels. You can see my butt drops. There's some butt wink, and my upper body is leaning pretty forward, which is very sub-ideal. And I could just feel my hips kind of weak when I was doing this without any core bracing. Yep, starts with a pretty arched lumbar curve and then it ends with some butt wink. Now I try to tighten my core as I went down and up. You can see me kind of like gasping air inside. And definitely there is less butt wink. You can see my lower back is very straight. Right here is when it kind of slightly goes in, but it's definitely better than before. And then this was after 5 minutes of third world squat stretch, like just being in the squat position. So what this did was my upper body angle was almost the same as before, but I could feel my hips being able to shove inwards more. Like I was in a deeper position. Maybe it's not visible that much, but I felt like my hips belonged in that hole a lot better. So this was a photo of number one and number two. After tightening my core, definitely my upper body went up, and after method three, my hips were slightly under. And then I did some hypertrophy work and all that. But I think today, I just wanted to show you guys my little experiment with the butt wink. And the conclusion being that, core tightness and, like the neutral back is really what makes the most difference. Anyway, see you guys in the next video.